Welcome this second online video session of module 2, which deals with phase control rectifiers. Today we can see a very important aspect of this phase control rectifiers. So two varieties are there. One is a single phase half wave controlled, another one is full wave controlled with R and RL loads. Today we can discuss on single phase half wave controlled rectifier with resistance load, R load. As you can see in figure 1A, which shows a simple circuit diagram for the half wave controlled rectifier with a resistive load. So here you can see single transformer is used with the single dot showing on both sides of primary and secondary will indicate that are using 1:1 transformer. So on the primary side we are applying single phase supply, and on the secondary side we are coupled with the same thing, that is a single phase supply. And for convenience of explanation, we are denoting this phase supply as em sin omega t, a function of a sine wave. Okay, so the same thing has been shown here, the supply voltage, that is a small e, that is equal to em sin omega t varying from plus to minus some amplitude at different angles of 0 to pi, pi to 2 pi, and 2 pi to 3 pi with respect to omega t. Okay, now on the secondary side we have the thyristor denoted by t1, and vt1 it will indicate voltage across t1 connected in series with the load resistance R. Okay, so this forms one closed circuit on the secondary side of the half wave controlled rectifier. Okay, so this completes a circuit explanation that we need to do it as a part of construction. Now let us see the operation here. Operation is very simple. So operation mainly consists of two parts of the one full cycle here. So let us consider one full cycle from 0 to pi of supply voltage, positive half cycle, and from pi to 2 pi, negative half cycle. So during 0 to pi, that is a positive half cycle, so when the input voltage is slowly rising from 0 towards the positive direction, our thyristor T1 is still in the blocking state. Okay, as long as this voltage we are there, as long as we are not applying any firing pulse there, okay, our T1 is not triggered. Okay, so even though our supply voltage is increasing in the positive direction, unless and until you apply the pulse at the gate signal, okay, that is called firing pulse. So in the last video we have discussed about two types of firing pulses. One is by using a level of pulses, another by using a level triggering. Okay, for the full level of the pulse your SCR will be on. Okay, so during this first firing pulse, before that you can see our thyristor is in the T1 is in the blocking state. Okay, so let us consider from 0 to alpha during this angle duration, that is omega t equal to alpha, our thyristor is in the blocking state, means still we have not yet applied any triggering pulse. Okay, so means this one is turned off, T1 is turned off, whatever the input you are applying, that is E at the secondary side, it is coming across T1 as VT1. Okay, so that's why you can see all the input whatever you are applying here, that is all the it is appearing across the SCR as VT. Okay, but as T1 is off, no current is flowing and hence no voltage drop across the output. Hence the load voltage VDC is zero and load current similarly is also zero. Okay, so this is what is happening during positive half cycle and just before applying the triggering pulse or firing pulse applied to the gate. Okay, so once you apply the firing pulse at an angle, phase angle alpha, okay, at this point, alpha, suddenly T1 will be turned on. Okay, so once the T1 is turned on, okay, then current will start flowing, that is a diode current will start flowing through the load and automatically will start getting the voltage drop across the R. So you can see load voltage will be start happening from alpha to pi. During that period our T1 will be on. Similarly, the load current is also going to follow the load voltage, but during alpha to pi of the positive half cycle, as T1 is on, there is no voltage drop across the T1. It may be there, but it is very small. Now here we are indicating it as ideal case 0. Okay, so this is what is happening, guys, during positive half cycle from 0 to pi. Okay, so just during positive half cycle, two things you have to keep in mind, two key points. Just before applying the firing pulse, our T1 is in the blocking state. All the input will appear across T1 as VT1 here. All input will appear across T1. And once you apply the firing pulse, our T1 will be turned on. And whatever the voltage was there across T1, now it is transferred to the load. Means voltage across T1 will be 0. Now during negative half cycle, that is from pi to 2 pi, our thyristor T1 is completely turned off. Okay, means whatever the input now you are applying, it is completely appearing across the SCR now. Hence, no output voltage or output current because SCR is off. So this situation is continuing as long as you are going to apply the firing pulse in the next positive cycle, next cycle. Till that, our thyristor T1 will be turned off. Means until you are applying next triggering pulse. Okay. Again, when you apply the triggering pulse in the positive half cycle of the next cycle, again the T1 will be turned on, and whatever the voltage across T1 was happening here, it is transferred once again to the load. Okay. Means what we are observing here is that during positive half cycle, okay, when thyristor is on, as thyristor is off, sorry, during positive half cycle, when thyristor is off, input will appear across the T1, input voltage will appear across the T1. When T1 is turned on, that same thing is transferred to the load, means VT1 is transferred to the load. This is what simply it is happening during both positive and negative half cycle. So this is how, guys, you need to explain the operation of the single phase half wave controlled rectifier with the R load. So this is the first thing is you have to draw the neat circuit diagram and explain briefly about its construction with all relevant parts and points. And second, for the explanation of operation, you have to take the help of these waveforms. So you have to practice these circuit diagrams and waveforms neatly, clearly with a black pen. Okay. Next, we can do some mathematical analysis. Okay, some small derivations which might be asked. I have seen many times it has been asked in the exam. So derivation for average load voltage. So average value of load output voltage. Now we can see that for one full cycle, we have to consider one full cycle here from 0 to pi during positive half cycle and from pi to 2 pi. Again, we can divide the full one cycle as from 0 to alpha, okay, alpha to pi and pi to 2 pi. So three parts we can divide here. So average value of load output voltage, we'll consider one full cycle, sorry. So just before applying the triggering pulse, we can take this period as 0 to alpha. Next we'll take from alpha to pi, during which our SCR T1 is on, and pi to 2 pi it will indicate negative half cycle. So we know that during this part and during this part, our SCR T1 is totally turned off. So these three terms, first and last term, will become 0. So only thing we left out is middle term, that is from alpha to pi Vm sin omega t d omega dt. Okay. Now take the constant thing outside, Vm by 2 pi, alpha to pi, sin omega t, d omega t. Means it is an integration of sine. So we know that integration of sine is how much? Okay. Integration of sine is cos. Okay. Now put the limits here. Cos omega t, upper limit will be pi, lower limit will be alpha. So it will become cos phi minus cos alpha. Cos phi minus cos alpha will get. And if you resolve this one, we will be getting it as 1 plus cos alpha. Vm by 2 pi. Outside it will be remaining as it is. Okay. Now let us see with the variation of phase angle, how our average load voltage is going to vary. At alpha equal to 0, at alpha equal to 0 means when your input is going to start here. At alpha equal to 0 means here at this point. So substitute for alpha equal to 0, cos 0 is going to be 1. 1 plus 1, 2, this 2 and this 2 will cancel, and left with only the DC value what we are getting, that is average load output voltage, we are getting it as Vm by 5. So this one we are widely using in solving the problems for single phase half wave control rectifier with half load. So next one, average load current, simply you need to divide average load voltage by R, that is Vm or Em by pi into bracket 1 plus cos alpha. Remember guys, the notations may be different, quite different, but their concept will be remaining same. But here you can see, here we have used Vm, and in the next slide I am using Em to just to make you to be conversant with different notations available. So next one, RMS load voltage, another derivation which has been asked many times. That is ERMS equal to 1 by 2 pi. Again, we have to consider alpha to pi only, because only during that period our thyristor T1 will be on. We'll take here RMS means it is a root mean square. Root means square root. Mean means 1 by 2 pi, the mean average value you are taking. The square means the square of the input what you are going to using, what you are using here. Next step, what we'll do, we'll take the constant thing outside. So this will become Em square. We'll take it outside, that is a constant. Inside the bracket or inside the integral what you have been left here, integral from alpha to pi, sin square omega t, d omega t. And now we replace this sin square omega t by using trigonometric formulas, 1 minus cos of 2 omega t by 2. So we know the formula, trigonometric formula, cos 2 omega t equal to cos square omega t minus sin square omega t, or 1 minus 2 sin square omega t by 2. The same thing we are solving it for sin square omega t, and that we are substituting here. Okay. If you simplify this one with the integration, so what we left here, integration of constant here it is going to be omega t, and integration of cos 2 omega t is going to be sin 2 omega t. Okay. And if you apply the limits pi to alpha, finally we are getting this expression for ERMS. That is ERMS equal to Em into bracket pi minus alpha by 4 pi plus sin 2 alpha by 8 pi. Again, if you apply alpha equal to 0, so what you have been left, this part term will become 0, and here pi will get cancelled, and what you are getting, so ERMS equal to Em by 2. Previously what we got, average load voltage, how much we got? We got it as Em by pi, and now we are getting it as RMS value as Em by 2. Okay, so these are simple derivations we have seen: average load output voltage, current, and RMS load output voltage. Next one, let us consider single phase half wave control rectifier with RL load. So in place of R, in series with R only, we are connecting inductance here. Okay. So again, circuit diagram you have to draw here. As shown in the figure, there is a typical circuit for single phase half wave control rectifier with RL load. There is a single transformer with a single dot on either side of the windings will indicate 1:1 transformer is used in the circuit. a single phase AC supply is applied at the primary side, and the same thing is coupled to the secondary and is denoted by Em sin omega t as shown in the figure 1A and 1B. Okay. So this is the supply voltage. So thyristor T1 on the secondary side is connected in series with load R and L inductance. VT1 will indicate voltage across thyristor T1, and EDC it will indicate total or average DC output voltage which is happening across R and L together. ID it will indicate the diode current when T1 is on. The circuit operation, guys, you have to take the help of waveforms here. So again, we have to consider one full cycle for the explanation of operation, that is from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so this will consist of two half cycles, 0 to pi positive half cycle and pi to 2 pi negative half cycle. Okay, so during positive half cycle, let us see, unless and until you apply the firing angle at omega t equal to alpha, my T1 is turned off, it is in the blocking state. Okay, as long as I will apply the pulse at the gate, our T1 is in the blocking state. Okay, from 0 to alpha, our T1 is in the blocking state, and so no load voltage EDC and no load current ID, and hence whatever the input you are applying, Em sin omega t, it is now appearing across T1 as VT1 like this. This whole input is now appearing across T1. So when you apply the gate pulse at phase angle alpha, our T1 will be turned on. T1 will be turned on. Okay. Once T1 will start connecting, then it will start getting the diode current which will start flowing R and L. Okay. So when the diode current will start flowing R, you start getting the load voltage drop, that is from T01 to T1. Okay. You start getting the load voltage. Similarly, the load current is also go on increasing, which is going to follow the load voltage. But one thing here is that what we are observing, our load voltage, the load current will go on increasing. Okay. So we'll come back to that one. So what is happening here is that when T1 is turned on, we'll start getting the ID. So that will start storing in the inductance slowly, like this, from alpha to around pi. From alpha to pi around, it will start storing in the inductance. But one important property of inductance is that it is an energy storing element. Okay, it will not quickly store and quickly release the energy. Okay, it will take some time to store the energy, and also it will take some time to discharge the energy. Now from alpha to pi, when the current ID was flowing, that has been stored slowly in the inductance L like this. Exponentially rising, it has been shown here. Okay. But during this period, the T1 is on, hence the voltage across T1 will be very much smaller, it is very much negligible, or ideally we have to put as zero, as shown in the graph. Now you can see, during positive half cycle, still during positive half cycle, that is from 0 to pi, okay, our load output voltage will become 0 at T1. Okay, but you can see this dotted line, it is indicating it is still increasing because load current has not yet reached 0. As we expected in the previous case, in absence of L with only R load, that became 0 at pi itself. Now as we have used L here, L is still, you can see, it is storing, and now it is discharging, it is still storing the, releasing the energy slowly here. It will take some time to completely lose the energy which was stored from alpha to pi. Now from pi to pi plus beta, during this period, our all current that is stored in the inductance, that is ID, will be discharged. Because of this, the load voltage which was decreased at pi equal to 0, which became 0 at pi, now will start increasing in the negative direction because of the existence of this current. Still the current is there in the inductance. Of course, it is decreasing, but still the current is there. Because of the existence of the small amount of current in the inductance, will make our load voltage to increase in the negative direction. This small peak what you are getting in the negative direction is happening because of the slow discharging, slow releasing of energy of the stored in the inductance. Now once at pi plus beta, that is at point beta here, okay, all the energy was released, no, then load output voltage will become zero, load current will become zero, and once the load output voltage will become zero, at that instant our T1 will be turned off and VT1 will appear like this. Whatever the input now will apply, that will apply appear across T1 like this. This situation will continue until you apply the triggering pulse in the next half cycle. Okay, again the same thing is happening. The only thing you have to remember, guys, is this one. This hatch part in the negative direction for your load voltage you are getting because of the slowly releasing of energy which was stored during positive half cycle with the turning on of the T1 in the inductance cell. Because inductance is an energy storing element which will store and release the energy instantaneously, not suddenly, instantaneously it will do it. Okay, so this is how, guys, you need to explain the operation of the single phase half wave control rectifier with the RL load. Now before looking at the derivation part, mathematical part, let us see for what duration our SCR is on. Okay, now our SCR is on from alpha to pi and pi to pi plus beta. Let us see how we is going to consider. So alpha to pi plus alpha only, okay, not from pi to pi plus beta, because here you can see the load voltage decreased in the negative direction, that is not considered as our output. Okay, our output is considered only from alpha to pi. So this duration was now decreased because of RL compared to R. So now if you resolve this one, okay, so same thing he has written. It has been assumed that in the negative half cycle SCR conducts for a period alpha. So alpha to pi plus alpha, you will be getting Em by pi cos alpha. It is clear that average load voltage is reduced in the case of inductive load. So here you can see this has been reduced here compared to the previous one in the with only R load. How much you got there? With only R load, you got it as 1 plus cos alpha, Em by 2 pi 1 plus cos alpha. Now how much you are getting? Em by pi, not 1 plus is there, only cos alpha is there. That means 1 plus means the 1 we lost there, means the output voltage got reduced by that much amount. This is due to the conduction of SCR in the negative cycle. So we are losing average output load voltage by some percentage here compared only with R load, because of the load voltage appearing in the negative half cycle. And this is happening because of the instantaneous storing and releasing energy of the inductance. Now, so this can be resolved with the help of the another diode that will be connected with anode at the bottom and cathode at the top side across the load. That is called a bypass diode or flywheeling diode, freewheeling diode. Now what is happening here? During negative half cycle, whatever the hatch now we are observing, okay, hatch we are observing now in the previous cycle, negative half cycle, your output voltage is increasing in the negative direction. That should be avoided so that we can enhance our average output voltage. Okay, so that can be done during negative half cycle. You can see your diode DF will be on. Okay, so T1 will be on only during positive half cycle. This is plus and this is minus. So when this is plus and this is minus during positive half cycle, T1 is on, and this will not come into picture because this is forward biased, and all our operation will be remaining as it is. Means unless and until you will apply the firing pulse, our T1 was in the blocking state and all the input will appear across the T1, that as a VT1 or VT. Once you apply the firing pulse at alpha, you are through the gate, your T1 will be turned on and all the input is transferred from VT to the load. Okay, also the current is also increasing. But now here the current is increasing even though inductance slowly releasing its energy. So what is happening here is that during negative half cycle, as T1 is off but diode is on, with the making of diode, this freewheeling diode on during negative half cycle, we are providing one closed path for the energy stored in the inductance to discharge it. Okay, so that's why we can see, so during all the negative half cycle, that's why it is denoted by the diode current slowly decreasing here. And again from 2 pi to this part, now our input is rising in the we entering in the positive half cycle. Okay, again our T1 appearing in the blocking state, the voltage across this the load current is very much smaller. Again it will start increasing, means during positive half cycle we'll start getting the thyristor current, and during negative half cycle we start getting the diode current. So with this case, with this situation, we are successfully able to remove that small hatch we got with the RL load in a single phase half a control rectifier with the help of this freewheeling diode. Okay, so this is a very important part that I have covered here. Operation once again will be remaining same. Only difference is that how you are getting IT and ID, that you need to explain. Rest of the things, the operation will be remaining same. Okay, so mathematically we can write it as EI sin alpha by EI equal to less, that is a duty cycle. So power factor, that is cos phi equal to more. Hence it is clear that the freewheeling diode helps in the improvement of power factor. So let us see some of the numericals here. Very simple numericals have been asked many times. So half wave controlled rectifier has purely a resistive load R. Okay, resistive load R is given with a delay angle alpha equal to pi by 3. Pi by 3 is it is given in terms of radians, because phase angle is given, should be measured in terms of radians. So determine, the rectification efficiency, some form factor, some 4 or 5 parameters he has asked. Let us go one by one. First one is a rectification efficiency, zeta equal to output by input, we know this one, that is output means DC output voltage, rectifier it is there, divided by the AC input, where PDC is a DC load power, that is ED square by R, we know this one. And PAC is the RMS load power, that is ERMS square by K, we have a relation, some K values there. So EDC is how much? First let us calculate EDC, because in order to calculate PDC, which will depend on EDC, we need to find out EDC here. We know from single phase half a control rectifier with RM load, EM by 2 pi 1 plus cos alpha is there. With RL load we will get only cos alpha. Okay, now with alpha equal to pi by 3, if you substitute here, that is cos 60, use the calculator, and if you resolve this, finally you will be getting EDC equal to this much, that is 0.24 times EM. Okay, now similarly for ERMS equation, for a single phase half a controlled with R, we know that EM into bracket pi minus alpha by 4 pi plus sine 2 alpha by 8 pi square root. Substitute for pi, substitute for alpha, that is pi by 3, and manipulate this one with alpha, that is pi by 3, you can substitute, that is 2 pi by 3 will get. Then finally we are getting ERMS as 0.48 times EM. So now we can make substitution for this one, EDC by PAC, EDC square by ERMS square. And if you resolve this one, you will be getting it as around 24% efficiency. So 24% only we are able to convert our AC to DC, that is the meaning here. Okay, so next one, the form factor. So some of the formulas here we are getting, you need to remember here. Form factor formula is ERMS by EDC, we got them. You substitute here, you will be getting it as 2.03, or in terms of percentage you will get it as 203. Ripple factor equal to form factor square minus 1 square root, will be getting it as 177%. TVF, transformer utilization factor, that is PDC by ES and IS, we know ES and IS are the RMS secondary voltage and current respectively. ES equal to mean value of the voltage by root 2. Similarly, IS equal to ERMS by R. Okay. So if you make the substitutions here, finally we will be getting it as 16.6%. And PIV, peak inverse voltage, for half year it is going to be EM, all we know it. So next one, another simple problem. An SCR is used to control the power of 1 kilowatt, 230 volt, 50 hertz heater they are using. Determine the heater power for firing angles 45 degree and 90 degree. We need to find out the power separately for the different reading angles of 45 degree and 90 degree. Okay. So we have the equation here for the half wave controlled. ERMS equal to this formula we have seen last problem. We make a substitution here. With the first firing angle, that is alpha equal to 45 means pi by 4. Alpha equal to 45 means pi by 4. ERMS equal to, you solve this one, how much you are getting? 155 volts. Okay. Then heat power W equal to ERMS square by R. If you do it, you will get that one. Okay. Now R we have to find out here. R, if you take it on that side, W will come in the denominator. ERMS square, that is 230 square by W, that is a watt is given, 1 kilowatt, will be getting it as around 53 ohms. Now we'll be able to find out the watt power here, how much power is delivered to the heater at 45 degree training angle. That is W equal to ERMS square by R. R is, you got it as 52.9. Substitute here, will be getting it as 454.15 watts of power is delivered to the heater at firing angle 45 degree. Similarly, if you work out in the same similar steps with the firing angle 90 degree, we are getting 250 watts. Means what we are understanding here is that as you go on increasing the firing angle from 45 to 90 degree by an amount of 45 degree, our power wattage delivered to the heater is also increased from decreased from 454 to 250 watts. Sorry, but I have seen the voltage here. So that one concept you should remember: increase of firing angle will results in decreasing the wattage required for the heater. That is very important. Okay, so this one thing we can learn. So this is how, guys, simply don't solve the problem. You try to draw the inference of what has been asked and what you got and what we have did there. Okay. So another small problem here. A single phase half wave controlled converter is operated from 120 volts and 50 hertz. Load voltage, load resistance 10 ohm. If average output voltage is 25% of the maximum possible average output voltage. Okay. So again, same things are coming here. I want you to go through them. So 6.4, another problem is there. So around 4 problems are there. So hope you can go through them. If you get any difficulty, you put the slide. We will try to explain that one. So we'll stop here.